Hello there. Good evening.
Hello.
How are you, Mariela
Bye, thank you. And you?
Fernanda? Fine too. Very good.
Good.
How was your weekend? What did you do on Saturday and Sunday?
Enjoy
You
because I
enjoy.
don't study.
Oh, that's true. You know, the only thing is that, I mean, thinking about the time that you have to be in front of the computer stresses you, don't you think?
Yes, it's a
Yeah, right.
stress.
So you are maybe watching TV and all of a sudden you realize that you have classes, right? Yeah, and I have to connect to classes. Well, so Saturday and Sundays are for you to relax. So I'm
Yes.
happy that you had a great time. Yes.
Yes.
Didn't you watch the Miss Universe, election?
No,
No.
I don't like that.
You don't like that? You know, I don't like it either. But for the first time in my life, I was in front of the TV with my husband and my kids because, I mean, it was in El Salvador. So I just wanted to check how everything, was going to turn. And well, the winner was one lady from Central America, so that's good. Yeah,
It's
that's good.
good. Nicaragua.
Nicaragua, yeah. And she's stunning. I mean, beautiful.
Yeah,
The
yeah.
girl is, I mean, she did a very good job, in all
Yes.
the different presentations. So I believe she deserves it, right?
Yeah.
Good. Jonathan, Jose Jonathan is with us. Hi, good
Hello, teacher.
evening. How
How are
are you?
you? Hi.
Bye.
I have a problem. I sent you a message.
A message.
I don't have a how do you say electricity?
Electricity. Do
Electricity.
so. You texted me today.
Yeah.
Really? Because I was checking your oral evaluation. So maybe because of that, I didn't pay attention to the other messages. But I mean, the good thing is that you are here with me right now, even if there's no electricity. Do you have electricity service now?
Only have 30 share carga share.
Ah, the percentage of your battery is only 30%. If you don't turn on your camera, I guess it's going to be enough, So stay connected as much as you can. Oh yeah, you look like a vampire in the middle of the dark. Okay,
Yeah.
thank you for letting me know, Jonathan. Yeah, stay connected. I mean, as much as you can because of the attendance, you know what I mean, right? Good. So welcome everybody, Fatima, Susana, Lucy, Ana Rebeca. Ana Rebeca is only a listener right now because she's on the bus, right? So I'm waiting, for the students who are missing or pending oral presentation. Yes. So I'm waiting for the videos. I'm waiting for the audio. Make sure you send it, okay? Before the end of the day, so that means right after the class. Well, the people I have to mention are not here yet. However, I have to say congratulations to most of you who took the exam. Yes, the first exam, unit number 1 and 2. And you got very good grades, my friends. The average is 8.79 for some of you, 9.7 for some, and they are tens. Lucy, you look like if you were in the middle of a tornado, Super, super windy. I love your hair. How
Thank
are
you.
you, Lucy?
I'm fine. I'm
Very
fine.
good,
Thank you.
very good. I am happy to see you. And Fatima also, right? Because you are the only two ladies with cameras activated. The others are shy. You know, they are like, I don't want the teacher to see me. But Insaform wants to see you. So you need to turn on the cameras. Let's see. Jose Marvin is here. Emily is with us right now. Hey, Jose Marvin. Good to see you.
Good to see you, teacher. Good evening.
Thank you. Good evening. How was your Monday? Did you have a great day today?
Yeah, I had a great day. Today excellent. I had a day off, but in the morning, I cut the grass.
I cut the grass,
and then I go shopping.
I went shopping. Good.
In the afternoon, I finished. Cut the grass.
So it means you had a very productive Monday, and that's good. Yeah, that's good. You need to take advantage of the time you are at home to complete all those activities, you know, that your wifey is asking you to do, right? Good, very good. So let's see, you know, it's time to start with the class. I have to say that Yanira Ortiz, Carlos Cesar, Rocío Ramos, Geldy Herrera, Genesis Margarita, and Jonathan Esau are the only students who haven't, and also Emily Vanessa, are the ones who haven't taken the exam, you know? Exam number one, unit number one and two. So please, do it as soon as possible because I need to have that grade, ready. Yes, so because time is flying, we are beginning a week number three. Yes, we are about to finish unit number three too, and that means that the other exam is coming. So if you wait too much to complete the evaluations, then you're going to go crazy with all the activities you will have to complete by the end of the level, you know, and there is a schedule and we have to stick to it, right? So if those students I mentioned are here, please take the exam and you are going to have till today after the class. Rocio, you are one of the students who haven't taken the exam. I don't have your grade. Let's see. Okay, let's begin with the class. Let's start with, you know, the class objective. I know you haven't practiced your English too much during this, the last weekend, because when you go on a weekend, you forget about the English classes, right? So it's time to start, you know, practicing, to start communicating, etc. So here we go. I'm going to show you my class objective. Let me share the PowerPoint presentation that contains it. And here it is. Let's have Lucy, you know, Lucy, I need you to help me with the class objective. What is it?
At the end of the lesson, participant will be able to make polite request.
Okay, listen to that. This is unit number three, okay? We are still working on unit three. About to finish it, but still on unit three, okay? And the class objective says, at the end of the lesson, participants will be able to make polite requests, right? Requests. What is a request, teacher? When we ask someone to do something for us, that is a request, okay? When you say, for example, teacher, can you repeat, please? That is a request. You are asking someone else to do something for you, okay? So we are going to study, you know, how to make those requests in a polite way, yeah? Because remember that English is about being polite, you know, when you are immersed in the culture, you're going to realize that you don't have to be tough when talking to people. Yes, you have to be as polite as possible. So here we go. This is the agenda. These are the specific, you know, points of it, right? We have the welcome, the warm-up activity, the class presentation, development, production, and the wrap-up. Okay, so let me show you what we have for the warm-up, you know? Let's go to this page. You know, I have prepared an activity where we can do two things, you know? First of all, we're going to have a little game, right? And then we're going to be practicing something that we began on Friday. Yes, you're going to remember things about Friday's class. So let's start with my crazy numbers. You know, I have Evelyn in the class. So Evelyn is going to be the icebreaker on this activity. So Evelyn, I need you to select one number, and this is only vocabulary, okay? Don't get like complicated, you know, like, what is the teacher talking about? This is just an icebreaker, okay? We are just breaking the ice with this activity. It's a vocabulary game. Pay attention to the word, game, activity, dynamic, whatever you want to call it. So, Evelyn, there you go.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening.
Number two,
okay, listen. This is guessing the word, the English word. You have to guess the word. Guess the word, Evelyn. Uh-huh. Combine the two pictures and tell me, what is the word in English? What is this?
Ice.
And what is this?
Ice cream.
Hey, excellent. That is ice cream, right? Very good. Well done. Now I want a boy for this. Cesar, Carlos Cesar, give me one.
Okay, 12.
Okay, very good. Guess the word, Cesar.
Our eyes.
So join it. Join the two. R. What is the sound of an R? The sound. R.
R.
The R. Sound. R.
I don't understand, teacher.
Okay, you have to combine. Ah, Evelyn. Okay, go ahead.
Rice,
excellent. You have to combine the sound of the R. What is the sound of the R? R. And what is this? I. So rice. Now you got it, Cesar. Rice is the hidden word. Okay. Next, Dina Damaris. There you go.
Number five.
Huh? Guess the word, Dina.
Dolphins, no.
Okay, let's see if it is Dolphins. Dolphin. Okay, at least you had the idea, right?
Okay.
Now, Jose Marvin, give me one number.
Number one.
Good. Guess the word. Ah, this is easy. What is this?
Bus.
And what is this? An adjective for how it looks.
No, teacher.
Okay, I'm going to help you. The adjective for this picture is dry. It's not humid. The opposite of humid is dry. So, bus, dry.
Ah, bus driver.
Ah, you got it, right? Bus driver.
Bus driver. Thank you, teacher.
We are exercising our minds, right? So here we go. Another lady. Let's listen to Lady Mariela. Lady, activate your microphone, please.
Hi.
Hi.
And three.
Okay, there you go. Oh, no. You are not winning any points, okay? So give me other number.
10.
10. Wonderful. Guess the word, lady. Huh? Look at this. Ah, this is very easy.
Pie.
Pie?
Rat.
Aha! Pirate, right? Pirate. Very good. Excellent. Okay. Now, let's see. I need a boy. Is Elmer Alexander here?
Yeah.
Okay, there you are. Give me one number, Elmer.
Well, 14.
14. Wonderful. Okay, guess the word. Where is the cat? Where is the cat? The cat is in a... I guess Evelyn wants to help you. Evelyn?
Basketball?
Basketball! Yeah, Evelyn is, you know, a pro in this, right? Basketball, right? Excellent. Now, let's see. Someone who has the camera off. Rubidia. Ruby, activate your microphone, please.
Hi, teacher.
Hi.
Number nine.
Okay, guess the word, Rubidia. This is difficult.
I don't know.
What is this?
Just.
What is this?
How do you say arena?
Sand.
Sand. Children's.
And what about the shh? You have at the end, huh?
I have.
Okay, there you are. Okay, tell me.
Sandwich?
Sandwich. Let's check if it is sandwich. Yeah, sandwich. Good. Some of you are like, huh? I didn't understand it. Okay, the purpose of this activity is trying to understand. Fatima Susena, give me one number.
Number seven.
Seven. Guess the word. Hey, this is a piece of cake.
Archer.
Armchair. Wonderful. Armchair. Nice. And Cesar was like, me, teacher, me. Cesar, why don't you try with other number then?
Okay, 15.
15? Ah, double points. No, my friend, because this is not an individual competition. Another one.
Four.
Okay, let's try with four. Ah, aha. This is very simple. And it's about Christmas, you know?
Snowman.
Snowman, wonderful. Yeah, that's snowman, right? Snow plus a man, snowman. Okay, next. Guzman Barrientos, Genesis Margarita.
Hola.
Hello. Number, please.
Okay, 16.
Okay, the last one here. Oh, another one, Genesis.
13.
13. There you are. So what's the word?
Watermelon.
Very, very easy, right? Watermelon. Water and melon? Watermelon. Lucy, would you like to?
Six.
Oh, no. Another one. 11 or 8?
11.
11. So, guess the word. Uh-huh.
No veo la imagen, teacher.
Really? You cannot see it? Look. What about now? What do you think it is?
I don't know.
What is the action here?
Play.
And what is it? What did you say?
Sound.
Playground. Oh, let's see. Yeah, it is playground. Excellent. Very good. You see, you can do it. You can do it. And the last one, Jose Jonathan. The last one is the last one here. Yeah, number 8. No option. Jonathan, guess the word.
Dry.
Ah?
Dry.
Okay, join it. With rain, train.
Train,
yeah, right? Not the rhyme, right? Train, you have to make one word in English. Good people, that was just to warm up, you know? Solo para que calentáramos, yeah? So congratulations to all of you, right? This guy is super fun, you know? He's hilarious. Okay, now let's get into business. And what is our business? Practicing and learning English, you know? So let's see. I have here a reminder or a refreshing activity related to Friday's, you know, class. On Friday, we were talking about making invitations, declining invitations, and also accepting invitations. Actually, I sent to you the vocabulary we were studying during the class, right? To the group, WhatsApp group, right? So what I want you now to do with me is, you know, to complete the next activity. I'm going to make it bigger. And there are some chunks from different conversations, and I want you to help me complete them. How are you going to fill here in the blanks? By helping me, you know, place these words all over the conversations, right? So, what do you think is the word that completes the first blank here? It says, I'm having a party to what?
Celebrate.
Ah, excellent. I'm having a party to celebrate. To celebrate what?
My birthday.
My birthday. My birthday. Yes. Excellent. My birthday. No beer day. Okay. Don't say beer day because everybody can have a beer day. Yeah. But birthday only once in a year, right? Hi, teacher, tomorrow I have a beer day. Oh, very good. You're going to drink a lot of beer, right? Next. I'm what?
Planning.
I'm planning a sleepover. Oh, let's see. Let's try with that one because for me it sounds logical. You know, I'm planning a sleepover. Have you ever had a sleepover, Rocio? Have you ever had a sleepover with other ladies?
My sleepover.
My friends?
With your friends. Okay, that's great, you know. For women, we gossip a lot, you know, during a sleepover. We listen to music, we eat, we put on some masks, you know, like to help our face to look beautiful the next day. So very interesting. The other, would you like to, this is a question. Would you like to? To come us? Mm-mm. It doesn't sound logical if you say, would you like to come us?
Join us.
Join us. This is an invitation, yeah? Would you like to join us? Join us? And what about this one? Can you
bring some food?
Can you bring some? What is some? Okay, here. Can you bring some food? And the last one, put it in your, another synonym for agenda, put it in your
diary.
Yeah, diary. Do you have a diary, class? That is old fashioned, right? Not anymore. That is so so romantic, teacher. That is so cheesy to have a diary, right? When I was a teenager, I used to have one, you know? And I used to write everything on it. But that is dangerous, too.
So, I have no time.
You don't have time now. Yeah. Adulthood is hard, my friend. Welcome, you know? When you are an adult, forget about time. Yeah, we are busy all the time. So, what happens with this one? I need two words here. I hope. Uh-huh. I hope you can.
Come.
You can come. Uh-huh. I hope you can come. Yes. Let me know. Yeah. Hope you
can make it.
No. Can make it. Hope you can. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Hope you can make it. And the last one, it is ing because you are supposed to use it here.
Inviting.
Everyone in our school year. Let's check the answers. Let's see. Plim, 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 plim. Uh-huh. Wonderful class. Beautiful. Nice. Completed game. And that is something that we studied when? On Friday. Making invitations, refusing invitations, accepting invitations, right? Accepting in a polite way, in a very friendly way, right? And vocabulary related to that. Okay, so we are going to continue with today's topic, and today's topic is about requests. So check this dialogue, please. Student A and student B. Student A says, would you like to go for a walk in the park? Check what student B answers. Sure. Can we go after lunch? And student A says, of course. Could you meet me outside my building? And student B answers, no problem. Pay attention to the words in bold, in phrases in bold. Look, would you like? And then we have, can we? And later, could you? What is all that, teacher? Okay, here we have a combination of invitation. We have a combination of request, right? And we have also here possibility, yes? So when you have, daily basis conversations, class, you can use all this vocabulary to interact with the other people, yes? So do it as much natural as possible. So if you pay attention again to the words in bold, they are modal auxiliary verbs. Would is a modal auxiliary verb. Can is a modal auxiliary verb as well. And also could is one. How do we use them then, teacher? How do we use would? How do we use can and could? Let me show you. We have this table here. And the chart is divided into the different modal auxiliary verbs that it's possible for you to use in different scenarios, in different situations, okay? We have the first one that is can. Can is used for, you know, different situations. Number one here says to ask somebody to do something. Like when you say, teacher, can you repeat, please? You are asking the teacher to do something. In this case, repeat what she said, right? The other, to ask for or give permission. Teacher, can I complete the exam tomorrow? You are asking for permission. Mom, can I go to the party? That is asking for permission. And the other is to offer to do something. Check the examples, people. Can you help me? What is can you help me? Is it asking somebody to do something, ask for or give permission or offer? What is can you help me? Hello?
Ask somebody.
I didn't get it. Repeat, please.
To ask somebody.
Very good, Fatima. To ask somebody to do something. Can you help me? You are requesting. You are making a request. Yes, you are asking someone to do something for you. And then the second example, can I have another chocolate? What are you doing here if you say this? Can I have another chocolate?
Permission.
In a way, you are asking for permission. My kids, you know, use this question very often at my place, you know? Mommy, can I have another chocolate? Mommy, can I have some chips? Mom, can I have blah, blah, blah? So they are asking for permission all the time. What about this? Yes, you can use my laptop. What is it? Is it permission again?
To offer to...
you can use my laptop. I am giving you the permission.
I am giving permission.
Uh-huh. I'm not asking. I'm giving the permission to use my laptop. No, you can't use my laptop.
Thank you.
Uh-huh. What is it? You are negating the permission. Yes, to do something. And the last one, can I help you with your bags? What is it? Is it request?
To
offer to do something.
To offer. That is an offer, okay? Yeah. When you offer your help to someone, that is, you know, exactly how you use the modal auxiliary can. Now, let's take a look at could. Could is used to ask somebody to do something, but it is more polite. Teacher, what is the difference about can and could then if it is used for permission? The only difference is that could is more polite than can. Yes, it's like similar to do you want and would you like? Yes, do you want is less polite than would you like. And the same happens with can and could. Can? And could, you know, the only difference in this scenario is that could is more polite, and that's it. Could you call me a taxi? No, can you call me? Sounds too direct. So instead, you can say could, right? Could you call me a taxi, please? And if you add the word please, it sounds even more polite, right? Could I come to work a little later? Do you think I could borrow your phone? Yes, so these are requests and also permission, but in a more polite way, yes? In a more educated way. And then you have may, yeah? Which is to ask for permission. May I speak to you for a second? Yes, you can say can, and you can say may, right? You are giving the permission, right? Or asking for permission in a polite way. Yes, you may use my laptop. No, you may not use my laptop, okay? And here we have the expressions we learned on Friday. Would you like? It's to make an offer or invitation. Would you like another chocolate? Would you like to go out? Will, which is asking somebody to do something. Peter, will you come here for a minute, right? And obviously for future, right? Future tense. And would, to ask somebody to do something. In a very polite way, right? Would you carry my bags for me, please? I have a backache. Yeah, this is asking in a very, very polite way, you know, to do something. Okay. Question so far? Or so far, so good? Any question, class? Or are you sleeping now? Are you there? No questions.
No questions, teacher.
Excellent. I love this class because you never ask questions to the teacher. You know, that tells me you are paying attention all the time. So very good. Let's move to the practice then. If you don't have questions, the teacher is going to ask questions to you. Okay, look at this. Requests and offers. Listen to a dialogue between a host and guest complete the four what? The four requests or offers and replies below. So here we go. Are you ready? Yeah, right? You're always ready. Action, action, action. Okay.
Can I get you something to drink?
Yes, please. A coffee would be nice.
How do you like your coffee?
With cream, please.
Do you take sugar?
Just one.
Here you are. Would you like to eat lunch now?
No, thanks. I'm all right. I ate on the plane. But could I just try one of those muffins over there? They look very tasty.
Yes, of course. Help yourself.
Thank you. Oh, before I forget, could I check my email from your computer? I'm expecting an important message.
I'm afraid the internet isn't working at the moment.
Okay, I'll just make a quick phone call if that's all right.
Sure, go ahead.
Do you have the answers?
No. Repeat again.
Okay, very good. Repeat again. Here we go. Here we go.
Can I get you something to drink?
Yes, please. A coffee would be nice.
Aha, okay. What is the phrase that he uses at the beginning of the question?
Can I?
Can I what?
Can you send it? No, can.
Can I get?
Can I?
Okay, don't worry. We are just trying, you know, to complete this. So, can I? You said?
Get.
Can I get? Okay, Elmer says, can I get? Can I get you something to drink? Okay, listen again.
Can I get you something to drink?
Uh-huh. Yes, please. A coffee would be nice.
Aha! Uh-huh. What is the answer?
Can I give? You?
Aha! Uh-huh. Yes, please. A coffee?
Would be nice.
Would be nice. Okay. Next.
How do you like your coffee?
With cream, please.
Do you take sugar?
Just one.
Here you are. Would you like to eat lunch now?
No, thanks. I'm all right. I ate.
Do you like to eat lunch now?
Would you? Okay, let me put all the words that you have given me. Okay.
Would you like to eat?
Okay, can I get the first one? And then you said would be, right? Would be, and here Genesis says?
Would you like to eat?
Would you like?
Uh-huh.
Oh, let's see.
Yo creo que no es you would like to eat. Porque es pregunta, ¿no?
No, because would is a modal auxiliary verb. Yeah, that is, would you like lunch now?
Do you like to eat?
Would you like to eat? To eat. We are going to confirm the answers, okay, once again with the listening. Don't worry. Let's leave it like this. So far, would you like to eat lunch now? And let's listen to the answer.
Eat on the plane, but could I just try one of those muffins over there?
No thanks. Back again, teacher. Rewind it. Okay, here we go.
I'm all right. I ate on the plane, but could I just...
Repeat again.
Okay, again. Here we go.
Please.
Oh.
No thanks, I'm all right. I ate on the plane. But could I just try one of those muffins over there? They look very tasty.
Yes, of course. Help yourself.
Thank you.
Can I get you something to do?
Wait. My audio. Okay, I want to write your answers.
I am all right.
Okay, all right. I'm all right. Uh-huh. I'm all right. And she says that she ate something on the plane, right? I'm all right. I ate something on the plane. So, the next one.
Here you are.
I ate on the plane, but could I just try one of those muffins over there? They look...
Aha! What is the question that she uses here in number three? People?
Can you...
Don't be afraid of making mistakes. Give me your opinions. Can you? Rocio says, can you?
Repeat the line.
Okay, repeat. Please. Okay, here. Don't worry.
But could I just try one of those muffins over there?
Aha!
Can I? No.
Listen?
I ate on the plane. But could I just try one of those muffins over there?
Aha!
Would you like? Could you like?
No. Listen back again. Listen.
No, thanks. I'm all right. I ate on the plane. But could I just try one of those muffins over there?
Uh-huh.
Could I?
Uh-huh. Very good, Brenda.
I heard would.
You know? And it's could. Could I? Right? Could I what?
Right, too.
Could I just try one?
Aha! Could I just
try
one of those muffins over there?
One of those muffins.
Uh-huh. They look very tasty. Yes, of course. Listen to this. Yes, of course. Oh.
But could I just try one of those muffins over there? They look very tasty.
Yes, of course. Help yourself.
Thank you. Oh, before I forget.
Uh-huh. What is the expression he uses? Yes, of course.
Help you.
Help yourself.
Like that? Help yourself. Okay, let me write it. Help. With capital because we are beginning the sentence. Help. Help yourself. This is a very common expression, you know, when someone comes over your house, for example, or when you have a guest at home, you offer something and then you say, help yourself, right? Help yourself. Let's see. Let's continue.
Could I check my email from your computer? I'm expecting an important message.
Uh-huh. What can you tell me?
Can I check my email?
Can I check my email?
My email.
Could you check?
Could you check? The person is going to
check.
Could I check my
email from your computer?
Of course, help yourself.
Could I check my email?
Oh, before I forget, could I check my email from your
computer? Uh-huh. Be careful with the pronunciation here. You don't say could. You say could, okay? Could I check? And be careful with check. Because you can pronounce another word if you mispronounce it. Okay, so be careful. Check. No, the other word. Okay, the dangerous English, you know? So could I check, right? Could I check my email from your computer? And then she says, I'm expecting an important message. And the person answers. Listen.
Computer, I'm expecting an important message.
I'm afraid the internet isn't working at the moment.
Okay, I'll just make a quick phone call if that's all right.
Mm-hmm. People, tell me. Class.
I am.
Genesis.
I am afraid.
I'm afraid. Okay, listen again just to confirm.
The internet isn't working at the moment.
Oh, wait.
I'm afraid the internet isn't working at the moment.
Ay, very good, Genesis. But with contraction, Genesis. I am, no, I'm, right? I'm afraid.
I'm afraid. The internet
isn't working at the moment.
Working at the moment.
Mm-hmm. This is the conversation. Look, you made it. You know, you did it, guys. You completed it. Okay, so it goes like this. Can I get you something to drink? Yes, please. A coffee would be nice. And then the coffee and blah, blah, blah. Would you like to eat lunch now? No, thanks. I'm all right. Could I try one of those muffins over there? They look very tasty. Yes, of course. Help yourself. Could I check my email from your computer? I'm expecting an important message. I'm afraid the internet isn't working at the moment. Okay, let's see. I need volunteers right now. One boy and one lady. Raise your hands. Thank you, lady. A boy. I need a boy now. I have the lady. Lady is the one. Manpower or the teacher picks. Cesar. Thank you very much, Cesar. So, Cesar, you're going to be letter A and lady letter B.
Okay.
Action.
Can I get you something to drink?
Yes, please, a coffee would be nice.
Would you like to eat lunch now?
No, thanks. I'm all right.
Could I just try one of
that has muffins? To be, this one has to be lady.
Be.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Lady?
Sorry?
In number three, you are the first one.
I am a letter B.
In number three, you are the lady. Lady.
Could I just try one of those muffins over there? They look very tasty.
Yes, of course. Help yourself.
Lady again.
Could I check my email from your computer? I'm expecting an important message.
Okay.
I'm afraid the internet it's not working at the moment.
Thank you so much. Look, intonation is very important, lady. When you say yes, there's a comma, right? Yes, please. A coffee would be nice. If there's a period, so I need to stop for a while. Okay, so you have to say, yes, please. A coffee would be nice, right? And then here, computer. So there are three syllables in the word, you know? Computer, the second syllable is a stress, right? Computer, right? And here, you don't have to say massage because massage is what I need right now. I need a massage right now, but this is message. The stress on the first syllable. Message, right? So thank you very much. I need another one, another pair. Thank you very much for your participation, class.
Yes, teacher.
Excellent. Evelyn and you. Evelyn the lady and you the man. Action.
Sorry.
Can I get it? Perdón, sorry.
Jonathan is the letter A.
Okay. Can I get you something to drink?
Yes, please. Coffee would be nice.
Would you like to eat lunch now?
No, thanks. I'm all right. Could I just try one of those muffins over there? They look very tasty.
Yes, of course. Help yourself.
Could I check my email from your computer? I'm expecting an important message?
I am afraid the internet is not working at the moment.
Okay. Look, thank you. Thank you. Check here. The pronunciation of this one is tasty. Like the A, you know, the letter A, tasty, tasty. A here is, look, check, 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 check. Okay? A here is expecting. Expecting, 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 right? And this one is important, right? Important, 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 right? Like that. Thank you. Thank you very much. Let's see. This is, you know, a conversation that contains exactly what we were studying previously. Along the explanation, you know, on how to request things, how to offer things, etc. So this is the first practice, you know. We're going to continue with more right now. Uy, you are going to go to breakout rooms to make invitations using the structure, would you like to? And you have to complete would you like to with most of the expressions you have here from the rectangles, you know? For example, you can tell your classmate, would you like to go to a movie with me tonight after the class? The person is going to decide if he says or she says yes or no. Please don't say only yes. Don't say only no. I need you to use the phrases that we studied on Friday. If you are going to decline the invitation, you have to say, I love to, but right now I'm so busy. I'm sorry. Yes? Or that sounds wonderful. Thank you. Yes, let's go. Yeah? So I need you to respond to the invitation using more than a yes or a no, okay? Don't be stingy. I don't need stingy people here. I need, you know, students who can use the language as much as possible. Is that okay? Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay, very good. You're here with me, right, guys? Huh? Didn't you have dinner before the class? Because you are so down today. Ah, come on. So here we go. Let's go to breakout rooms and I'm going to send a picture of this activity to the group, right? To the group as I usually do. Okay, there we go. I'm going to create the breakout rooms right now. I have 20 participants. Well, 19 with me are 20. Let's see. There you go.
Good evening.
Hi, good evening. I am alone. Hace ratos.
Yo dije, me voy a dejar practicando sola.
Me too.
Yeah. Start.
Yes.
Okay.
Dijo ella que preguntáramos que tuviéramos fluidez, ¿verdad? De continuar la...
Would you like to come to my party, for example? Y digamos, como invitar, hacer la invitación y luego responder, ¿verdad?
Sí, correcto. Por ejemplo, si yo le pregunto, would you like take a walk?
Would you like?
Take a walk.
Yes, of course. I would like to walk because I like to have money.
Okay. Si usted me pregunta a mí.
Okay. Would like to
core crazy? Crazy core?
Core.
Okay. Would you like to come?
Hablemos del carnaval de San Miguel.
Carnaval de San Miguel.
Nunca he ido.
Miguel en carnaval.
Well, to Athens for visit in Chennai. ¿Cuál es tu dirección para visitarte toda esa noche? Para no perderme. Would you like to go shopping in the carnaval? ¿Qué le gusta comprar en el carnaval?
I like to buy cord crazy or crazy cord. ¿Es lo de loco? Churros, yes. Españoles.
Oh, yes. Enredado de yuca. ¿Cómo se llama? Yes.
Would you like to have a lunch?
Yes, I would like to have a lunch with you. Would you like to go shopping with me?
Yes, I would like go to shopping with you. And do you like to hang out this weekend?
Yes, I would like to hang out this weekend. Would you like to have dinner?
Yes, I would like to have dinner. Would you like to play baseball?
No, I would like to play baseball. Sorry. Would you like to
yo creo que cuando es no, creo que es
I wouldn't like play baseball.
Can I help you, ladies?
Yes. Yes.
If you say no, I wouldn't like it, it is like very it sounds like not that polite. So you better say I love to, but I can't, or I'm sorry, that sounds fantastic, but right now I'm busy. You decorate the no, you know, the no answer. Instead of saying no, I wouldn't, yeah, you have to say something else to sound like friendly or polite with the other person. Okay, so don't say no, thank you, but instead of saying no, thank you, or no, I wouldn't like, you can say, I would love to, but I can't, or I, that sounds fantastic, that sounds terrific, but I don't have time to go right now. Something like that, you know?
Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Would you like to go Lee skating? Would you like to go ice skating?
Yes, I would love.
Teacher Anna is not here.
Yeah, I forgot. You know, Anna is on the bus right now, so I'm going to send someone here, Jonathan, so you can practice. Let me see who is available. Yes?
Yo estaba haciendo un pequeño diálogo para...
Okay, that's wonderful. Are you writing it?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to send right now Sarah to this, okay, to this you know, breakout room, so you can share with her. Okay, so let's see, this is room 5, right? So yes. I'm going to send Sarah, right? Well, let's hope she comes quickly. Ah, here she is. Sarita, you are going to talk to Jonathan because he is alone, let's say. Rebecca is here, but Rebecca can't participate because she's on the bus right now. Okay, so go ahead.
Estaba con Dina, pero...
Elmer is now with Dina.
Oh, okay.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Don't worry.
Okay.
Okay, Jonathan. Thank you. Yeah.
¿Pregunto usted primero o yo?
Hello, Elmer.
Sorry, I have problem with my internet.
Okay. Don't worry.
Dina, Elmer is having problems with his internet connection. I'm sorry if I took Sarah, you know, to other room, mm-hmm, but there was other student who had nobody with him. So if you want, maybe you can go back to the main room. You can leave the breakout rooms and wait for the rest of the class there, because you practice with Sarah, right?
Yeah, yes, teacher.
Okay, very good, very good. So I'm going to give a minute to the rest of the groups, and I'll see you there in the main room. Okay?
Okay, teacher.
Good. Thank you.
What time? Excellent.
Oh, excuse me.
Okay. No problem. Yes, of course. What time is it?
Excellent. It's tomorrow at 6 o'clock p.m.
Perfect.
Okay. Perfect. Me faltaba.
There you are, people. Thank you. Thank you very much. I'm sorry if you didn't have like enough time to complete all the invitations. But because of the time, you have to come here with me. Let's see. let's wait for the other students. Okay, yes, I have everybody. Good. You know, I was like checking that some of you were making conversations. You know, you were writing the conversations down. You were creating a dialogue. And that's very good. I mean, because that helps you to organize your thoughts, your ideas, etc. So let's have, you know, one of the groups I monitored that were writing conversation down. That is Cesar. Cesar and Francisco, right? Yes. Okay. Yeah. So, action. I need to listen to you guys. Go ahead.
Would you like... Sorry. Would you like playing... Okay. Would you like play video games with me?
Yes, of course. Where we play video games?
In my house with other friends.
Excellent. What time is it?
At 5 o'clock p.m.
Nice. See you later.
See you.
Okay, what time? What time? If you say what time is it, it sounds to me that you are asking for the time, you know, that you are requesting the time. So what if you don't say, what time would it be? Yeah, what time would it be? The invitation, right? Would it be? What time would it be? Ah, 6 o'clock or after the class, right? Or at 8. Yes, so things like that. Very good. That was the only invitation, Carlos César, or you were practicing with other option from the list?
Oh, yes. The other conversation with Javier is, could you like to come to my party, Javier?
Yes, of course. When is
the party? When is the party, right?
When is the party?
The party is in my house. Is tomorrow at 6 o'clock p.m.
Sounds good. Sounds good, you can say.
Sounds wonderful.
Sounds wonderful. Great. Very good. You know, one of the skills that you need to develop is improvising. You know, improvising is good because you never know what the other person is going to say, right? So you need to be ready, you know, ready and think on your feet. Yes? Thank you. Thank you very much. Now let's listen to Jose Jonathan. Yes, Jonathan and Sarah had little time to prepare, but maybe you can show us a little bit of what you were saying.
Okay. Sarah asked me.
Okay. Jonathan, would you like to go to the festival?
Of course. Where is?
Sorry?
Where is?
Where is the festival?
Where is the festival?
The festival is in my city, in La Union.
Okay. What time is start?
Start at 8 p.m.
Okay, it's a good idea. I see you. I see you in La Union.
Imagine Jose Jonathan is from Chalate, and Sarah is from La Union. So. Literally, Jonathan needs to cross the country to arrive to the festival. Yeah. Wow. But he said, yes. You know, he's open to whatever invitation. Yeah. That's very good, Jonathan. Excellent. And Jonathan can bring the music, you know, because he's the DJ. So that's why Sarah is inviting you. You know, I know what she wants. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Now let's listen to Brenda. Brenda and Jose Marvin, right? You were working together.
Right, teacher.
Good. Action.
Hi, Brenda. Would you like to take a walk?
Yes, of course. What time?
Tomorrow at 5 o'clock.
Okay, perfect. Where are you going?
Take a walk.
Where are you going to walk?
I could like to Centro Histórico.
Oh, that place is beautiful. I would like to now.
You would like to do it now? Brenda?
What?
You would like to do it now. I would like now, you said.
I could love now the place because it's beautiful.
And to know. I would like to know the place. I understood. I would like it now. Not tomorrow. Now. I want it now.
I would like to know
the place. Yeah.
To know the place.
In pictures, it looks amazing, right? Especially at night with the lights on, etc.
Yeah.
Great. Very good. Thank you. The new library. That's the main attraction nowadays, right? Everybody wants to go. Thank you so much. I want to listen to Rocío. Rocío was working with?
With Fátima.
With Fátima. So, action, ladies.
Hi, Fátima.
Hello, Rocío.
Would you like to come to San Miguel Carnival with me?
Yes, first time.
Okay. Would you like to dance?
I don't care.
I can dance.
Okay.
Did you? Yes, I can dance and I like dance.
Would you like to have dinner or eat in the park?
Can you repeat, please?
Would you like to call Chris?
Repeat the previous question, Fatima. Would you like to have dinner? Or eat something in the park.
I like to eat belly whey meat in the party.
That's exotic.
Yes. It's the traditional dinner in the carnival.
Really? Belly
whey is
the traditional? Belly whey, yes. Oh, I didn't know about that. I just knew that carneadas were very, very popular, you know?
Yes.
So that's, you know, belly whey meat. Yes.
Would you like to eat belly whey meat, Fatima?
Yes, in the river for tourists. Agua caliente. Por primera vez.
She said she tried belly whey for the first time when she went to Agua Caliente, the river. You went to the river, right, Fatima?
Yes.
Okay, that's good. Excellent. So, Fatima is attending the carnival with Rocío, right?
Yes.
Very good. Thank you. Thank you so much. Now I want to listen to the last one, the last pair, because we don't have like enough time to listen to everybody, but I guess Evelyn can help us. Evelyn? Miss Chicos. Is Evelyn available? Is Evelyn here? Evelyn? No. Okay, Emily then. Mrs. Escobar, Emily, Vanessa.
Hello.
Okay, who was your partner in the breakout rooms?
Me. She's the girly, Carly. Hey.
Carly. Who is Carly? No.
The colochita.
the curly one. And who is the curly one here? I have many curly ones.
And Lucia.
Lucy. Ah, okay. Lucy was with you. Lucy, activate your microphone if you are here with us. I guess Lucy.
Lucy mandó un mensaje al WhatsApp, dice que tiene problemas de audio, pero ahí el grupo lo ha mandado.
Ah, yeah, now I'm checking it right now. Okay, so, Genesis, invite Emily right now to do something with you. Let's improvise.
Lady?
Emily, Emily is your partner right now. Emily.
Ah, Emily, who is yeah. Emily?
Emily. Emily is the lady with the microphone.
Ya la vi. Okay, los que están ahí, yo puedo decir cualquiera.
No, the ones from the list, please.
Ay, pensé que tenía activa la cámara. No. Would you like to go to a movie with me? Emily?
Emily, would you like to go to a movie with Genesis?
Ask her when, what time?
2 p.m.
When day?
The next Saturday.
The next
Saturday.
Next Saturday. Uh-huh.
Of course, I will go with my daughter. No problem.
No problem. Is your daughter will be a friend with my son?
So amazing, Emily.
Oh, sorry.
Okay, I suppose Emily is with her daughter right now. That's why she is like,
yes.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much. We are moving to the next activity because we have to cover many other, you know, things. Let's open, please, the chat. I'm going to send this link to you right now. You are going to work individually. Yes, individually with some exercises. Okay, some exercises. So I'm going to send the link and you have to complete the requests that you are going to check, you know, in the on the page or all over the exercises you're going to find there. Check the link here on the chat room, Zoom chat room, please. There you have it, and I will also send it to WhatsApp just in case it is better for you to check it there. Ah, I sent the list of students who haven't taken the exam. Tienen que tomar el examen esas personitas que mandé al grupo, okay? Because I have been checking the grades and you do not appear in the list, okay? So please. In the meantime, you can work on the exercises right now. Is this one. Sorry for the advertisements. You know, this page contains a lot of adverts, right? But don't pay attention to them. It's not a sponsoring because they don't give any money to the teacher, but let's check the exercise. The exercise says, choose the correct option. You have a multiple choice activity. There are some questions, some short, very short conversations where you have to select the correct option. And later, in the next exercise, you have to write the questions by putting the words in the correct order. You have, you know, scrambled sentences. You have to order them on the provided space. Thank you. Elmer, we are working on an exercise. You have the link on the chat, WhatsApp chat, just in case you.
Yeah, I did it.
Okay, great. As soon as you finish class, you know what you have to do, right? Take a picture, send it to the group, and that is the evidence of today's work, right? Don't forget it. There's no picture yet, so it means to me that nobody has finished with the exercise. There's the first one. Let's see, let's see. Daniel Efrain, right? Very good. Daniel, the only... Oh, the second part was a problem, right? Sally needs to be capitalized because Sally is a proper noun, right? So you were supposed to capitalize Sally, right? Can Sally play with volleyball with us? That was the problem. Can I use your phone, please? I don't see any problem with this one. Let's see this one. Can you close that door, please? Can you please close that? Maybe it could be the word please that you have to place it at the beginning, right? Not at the end in this exercise. Okay, let's check. Lady, Ovidia. Okay, let me help you with the second exercise because I see that some of you are having those as wrong answers. Okay, let's do it together. Let's do it together here. In the first part, number one has to be, can I, right? Can I borrow your pencil? And then you say, no problem, here you go. Number two, can he help me with my homework? Because it is a question, right? And no, he can't, right? He's busy. Number three, can you give me a ride home? Sure. We can meet after 10, right? Number four, can he lend us his car tomorrow? Yes, he can. Number five. I can't carry all these books. They're too heavy. They're too heavy. Can you help? Can you help me? I sure can, right? On the second part, ladies and gentlemen, here you have to say, can I, or can Sally, right? Can Sally, capital letter, can play. Sally play? Because if you make a mistake with the spelling, etc., the system is going to get that as a wrong answer. Can Sally play volleyball with us? With us? With us? And there's a question mark, right? And then the second one. Listen, here is the problem with most of you. You have to say here.
Yes.
Yes, Ruby?
Excuse me, speak Spanish. En la primera de Sally, yo lo puse así y me la dio incorrecta. Y a Mariela se la puso correcta, entonces no sé si es error del sistema o algo.
Ah, ¿Tiene algún error de spelling usted en alguna palabrita? Si se le fue alguna letra, se lo identifica como incorrecto. Can I use your phone? Can I use your phone? And listen, here is the problem. You need a comma to separate the word please. Comma, and then please. Okay? Like this. Can I use your phone? Please, comma, and please. Okay, that's why some of your answers were taken as incorrect because you didn't use a comma here to separate the please word, okay, from the question. Can I use your phone? Please, comma, and please. And then.
Sí, creo que ese fue el problema porque igual yo la puse así como usted la puso, solo que sin la coma y me la marcó mal.
Ajá, so the coma. You have to include the coma to separate the word, okay? And then you say here, the number three. Can you, capital letter, right, at the beginning. Can you, what? The verb, close what? That door, and then comma, please. Right, and then question mark. Then the number four. Can we all, right. Can we all what? Go to the game? And then the question mark. And the last one. Can I what? Join the bear? Can I join your drama club? And then you close with the question mark, okay? Because in some of the exercises, that was the problem, right? The comma in some parts, etc. So I'm going to share the results with you just in case, only for you to see, okay? This is, you know, the outstanding result because I included the comma here. Do you see? Right? So all the answers were accepted. If there's no problem with the system, is sometimes that we forget to include those punctuation marks. Punctuation marks are important in the formal English, in the academic English. Okay? So having said this, you know, we don't have like enough time to cover the last exercise that I had prepared for today. So we are close to say bye-bye, right? Because of the time. However, I need to tell you that some of you haven't worked on the oral presentation that I needed for today. So please send the oral presentation, take the exam, tome el examen, because that was supposed to be done by Saturday. So I need that grade ASAP, you know, as soon as possible. So maybe you can stay with your computer after the class and take the exam without any problem. And then I will be checking the results tomorrow, okay? Just to give you the chance, right? And, well, there are other students who haven't sent either the second homework assignment, right? So make sure. A dónde está dito, mire lo que me falta, puede decir usted. Mandé la tarea 2. Si lo hizo, cheque sí. Si no, trabajemos en eso rapidito y se lo puedo aceptar todavía el día de hoy, ¿ok? Please, take the exam. Yo sé que son personas muy ocupadas, sí, pero tómese un tiempito ahí. El examen no está difícil, ¿ok? ¿Rosy?
Ya la tengo, el David. Ay,
ah, no sé. Okay, very good. So send it to me.
WhatsApp.
Yeah, please, to my private, a mi privado. En tanto yo pueda tener el tiempo para observarlo, tomar notita de algún feedback que le pueda dar. Los compañeros que ya lo hicieron, ya recibieron su nota y todo, ok. Así con las anotaciones de tal vez lo que puede haber hecho un poquito mal y lo que puede mejorar ahí, y así lo va a recibir usted también, ¿ok? So, maybe not tonight, I mean, because the teacher needs to eat and needs to sleep, but tomorrow during the morning, okay? Or during the day. I don't promise that that is going to be in the morning because I work in the mornings, okay? So maybe in the afternoons I will be sending my feedbacks to the ones that I am pending here. Yes? So far we can say bye-bye because it's time to finish with the class. So I'm going to see you tomorrow at 6 sharp, you know, be punctual, don't skip the classes, stay with me, right? And I'm so sorry for the ones who have been taking who have been having problems with the internet. That happens during, you know, online classes, so it's a pity that I couldn't have you the complete session, right? Thank you very much. I'll see you tomorrow. Enjoy your bed and work on the exam, the ones who haven't taken it, right? And I'll be meeting with you tomorrow, right? Thank you, guys. Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye, teacher.
Bye.
Good night.
Good night, everybody.
Bye, see you.
See you.